On May 5th, boxing star Olaf Alabi will enter the ring to face Marco Huck. And let me tell you, it might be a crime scene. They'll have to call CSI Miami to clean up the mess.
You might need to call in Miami, Vegas, and New York. It's gonna be some mess.
Training really hard right now at the Gold's Gym. We're here in Venice, California. The sun is shining. Yeah. Been training with, I have to give a lot of props to Harold Parker, who's his conditioning coach, who really gets Ola ready before he goes over to start his boxing training with Fritz. And Harold's worked with guys like Dr. Dre, he's worked with Shane Mosley before, with James Toney, and so he's a really well-respected fitness and conditioning coach, and he's gotten Ola to the point now where, you know, we're getting ready to go.
Taking him out one punch.
Hey, Adam, really quick, Adam. This is Olaf Alabi. He's gonna go fight for a world title. He trains with the Klitschko's all the time.
Nice.
Have you seen him on CSI Miami?
Yeah, that's my man.
After his fight, you gotta come investigate the crime because he's gonna kill his opponent.
That's good. That shouldn't be hard to find. Yeah.
Where's the fight?
Germany is May 5th.
Yeah. Usually they pack out the stadium, so.
Germany love fights, man. Thank you.
Look, a very talented actor.
Yeah,
he's gonna come investigate the scene.
Yeah, because he might just come in the ring, see blood everywhere, be like, "Fuck it, there was a murder. I'm gone." Because I'm gonna put hands on him, you know.
Ola's gonna go over there and snatch the belt from Hook, so he'll have to go investigate.
This one thing I'm gonna tell people: this won't be a disappointing fight. This won't be one of those fights where I'm inactive and all that. I mean, if I take one punch, I'm gonna give him two. You know, it's gonna be either a war or a boxing fight. I prefer if it's a war because, I mean, I'm twice as strong as I used to be. You know, so I just want to give it a shot. You know, see what's up. You know, because
you look huge. You look like you're in great shape.
Yeah.
I mean, it's one thing when you train a wild card. It's sometimes tough with all the big superstars for you to get the attention because they're focusing on the Mannies and the Amir Khans and the Chavez Jr.
Yeah, but you see, I've always known my place, you know. I come into the wild card, I chill, I play with people. I don't care about what's going on with those guys and I don't get noticed. That's an ego thing, and you know? I come in, I do what I have to do, let the work show people that I'm here, you know what I mean? And I've been slowly, gradually proving myself, and now people recognize me. People are talking to me, people are asking for autographs. I don't even have one photograph on the wall of wild card. But I'm not crying. There's guys in there that just walked in like 2 months ago. I've been there 11 years. They got photos up with their like belts or NABFs. So I don't care about all of that. I just gonna get some checks in.
Hey, you with K2 Promotions now. That, would you rather have a picture on the wall or work with Tom, you know?
I don't know. That's a hard one. Let me think about it. Because I do look good in pictures.
Pictures don't make any money for
you. Yeah, pictures don't pay the rent, bro.
You know what? It's going to be a big mess, but Olaf Alabi going for the world title May 5th. You won't want to miss it. From the Gold Gym in Venice Beach, for ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekback reporting. You can follow me on Twitter, @Sekback.